Welcome back to the show. Where we last left off at Fostoria was watching CSX coal train C601 coming off of the Columbus subdivision northbound, turning westbound onto the Willard subdivision. We return now to the park after getting lunch to set up for southbound train B522 as he comes off of the Pemberville sub and takes the northwest connection onto the Willard subdivision. B522, as you probably are well aware by now, is the steel slabs train that comes out of Detroit and heads for Middletown, Ohio Rolling Steel Mill.
So first we're up. What is I think at the I could be wrong.
I'm first now that you didn't smile at.
Surprises in store as a northbound CSX green train comes straight through on the CNO mainline. The CSX dispatcher had quite the mess to clean up at Fostoria today. About 10 minutes after B-522 and the grain train leave the scene, southbound intermodal train I-151 gets his permission to take the connection.
Thank you.
After I-151 gets out of the way, CSX clears the diamond for train I-132 to come across next. As usual, train I-132 has its Union Pacific power and manifest freight traffic for Wallbridge. Seeing trains run straight north or straight south on the CNO mainline is not as uncommon as it once was in recent years. In recent years, you were lucky to encounter this once a day, sometimes twice a day or three times if you were really lucky. Nowadays, it happens so many times, it makes good photo opportunities.
Thank you.
After I-132 had left the scene, CSX train ran M-369 over on the Willard subdivision. Unfortunately for me, I was way too late to get over there, so I just set up at the park and zoomed in the camera. It ain't much, but, you know.
The dash eights, one neat thing about them on the control on the electrical control panels, they can toggle motor in and out.
What does motor in and out do?
It's basically engaging whether the traction motors on each truck. We have 3 traction motors per truck for a total of 6 traction motors. So basically what you can do is you can toggle whether or not each individual traction motor was on and applying power or not.
That's
the simplest way to put it. But essentially, if you turn one on, you're driving your overall amperage up.
It's kind of useless then.
But if you're doing low haul or just an engine move in general, if you're just moving 2 engines or so many, you don't really need to have a whole bunch of motors in.
Unless if you're the Conrail dash
eights. Right.
Here's the thing. Every single railroad that ordered the dash eights, every single one of them worked. But
because Conrail wanted some sophisticated piece of shit.
I don't even know if it was that, but it was the specific specification that they asked for from the units.
What, high-tractive effort?
I don't remember what they asked for. They asked for some specific specification.
Also, what was the point of the C41-8 with 125 extra horsepower?
That's what they were originally supposed to come with.
Oh, I didn't know that.
The Dash 8 was originally supposed to come with 4,100 horsepower, but the Santa Fe fucked that up.
What, for only 40?
No.
For like 4,000 horsepower?
Yeah, that might be 631.
Or is that the NS?
That might be...
I don't know the... I don't follow what manifest stuff comes
through. Might be... 635 taking the corner down.
Still taking the corner going that way.
Yeah, it goes towards Marion, right?
Wait.
Oh,
wait.
Oh.
He's coming around this way. He's going around the turn. Oh, yeah. Wait. Hey, dash 8. I think that's a dash 8 trail, isn't it?
I'll have to look at that.
Yeah, dash 8. Oh, yeah, it is.
A surprise is in store as CSX train M215 takes the corner past F Tower to head north. Surprisingly, M215 has another C40-8W. Unsurprisingly, it's trailing.
Detector NS.
Thank you.
I saw an ACU on that. I saw an ACU going through off of Chicago.
ET44AAH.
Plus they put out a lot.
After waiting for well over 45 minutes, the CSX dispatcher turns a Norfolk Southern manifest freight that had been waiting west of Fostoria loose. For the amount of hype the fellow railfans had put into this train, really wasn't much to look at. After this Norfolk Southern mixed freight, whatever symbol it was, left the scene, I moved over down to a favorite spot of mine, the old Baltimore and Ohio Depot. I had plenty of time to spare. About 40 minutes after the NS mixed freight was long gone, the CSX dispatcher sets up a meet between trains I-137 and M-506. Track crews had a work window for the entire day to replace the ties.
Thank you.
506 was a monster of a train today, having nearly 900 axles. M506 is a Queensgate Yard in Cincinnati to Walbridge, Ohio train that normally takes the Toledo sub all the way, but they haven't been running them that way lately. For some reason, the preferred routing seems to be taking the connection at Deschler and then running out this way to Fostoria, where he then takes the turn onto the Pemberville sub and up towards Walbridge that way. I do not know why CSX wouldn't just run it straight up the Toledo sub all the way, but I'm not complaining. Barely even 10 minutes later, the CSX dispatcher gives the signal for a Norfolk Southern manifest freight to run through the interlocking. One C-44-9W is all that's needed to pull this manifest freight on towards Elkhart. A while later, and on the same track as the last NS train, another manifest freight makes its way through Fostoria, this time heading east. I am only making a guess, based on the automobile frames in the consists, that this is NS train 12Q, but I could be wrong. A Union Pacific GE and a Kansas City Southern GE have graced this job today. Only 2 days prior to this scene being shot, the Kansas City Southern was its own railroad company, and is now part of the Canadian Pacific Kansas City Railway. it is once again CSX's turn, and this time they send train M511 around the corner here at Fostoria. M511 is a Detroit, Michigan to Cincinnati, Ohio train, and it is also one of those trains that when it arrives in Wallbridge, it normally takes the Toledo sub all the way to Cincinnati. But today he doesn't do that. Today he goes south on the Pemberville sub, where he makes a right turn here at Fostoria to go out towards Deschler, where he will make a left turn at Deschler to get on the Toledo sub from there. M511 is also another monster with over 800 axles. After M511 left the scene, most of the rail fans moved from the park and down to here, where they all set up for the train that everybody wanted to get. The train in question turns out to be I-165, the regular CP, now CPKC, trackage rights train. Today, I-165 has a surprise on him. CREX, now Canadian National GE, trails on I-165 today. Seeing I-165 would also make it my second official CPKC train since the merger took effect on April 14th, 2023. Sun gleaming off the side of the containers, CSX train IO16 comes to after Fostoria having meeting the I-165 at God's End. I-016 is one of the many trains on this line that CSX dispatchers try to expedite across the system.
Thank you.
As the light continued to dip low on the horizon, that meant my time at Fostoria was coming to an end. But the railroad wasn't done yet. CSX Manifest Freight M560, the regular Queensgate Yard to Selkirk, New York Manifest Freight, comes through Fostoria in relatively good evening light. M560 would be meeting westbound train IO-17 somewhere east of Fostoria. As was advertised, train IO-17 comes through Fostoria westbound, having met M560 somewhere east of here. The other horn you are hearing in the background is of train L-343, which had come through just moments before to drop off one car for the grain elevator. The Norfolk Southern tracks come alive one more time in the form of another eastbound, with one BNSF Heritage 2 C44-9W up front, and one Heritage 2 C44-9W on the rear. This would be the last Norfolk Southern train for me at Fostoria, the rest would all be CSX freights. Thank you. rest of the action at Fostoria would be purely CSX, as it normally is. CSX train M201 takes the connection here at Fostoria to head on west towards the Chicago area. Most, if not all of these cars are heading for the Indiana Harbor Belt Railway.
Thank you.
CSX train I-009 is the next train to make its appearance. Like its sister train I-010 that we missed earlier, train I-009 is loaded down with lots of UPS trailers. This makes it a priority train for dispatchers to expedite across the system. The last train of the day, at least for most of us, would be in the form of CSX train B523, the sister to the B522 that we saw earlier. Thank you. With B-523 heading off towards Detroit, this brought to a close our day here at Fostoria. Today saw just over 30 trains in power from all six of the Class 1 railroads. Not bad for a nice 70-degree Saturday in the springtime. Now it was time for me to go get some nice warm chicken fingers at Cane's. So, until next time, see y'all out on the high iron, and as always, go Buckeyes!